Hello guys and welcome to Explanator. Today's video is about impedance transformation in a single phase transformer. Why do you need one and what are the steps for the transformation? Consider an ideal transformer connected to an inductive load. Let the turns ratio between secondary and primary, that is N2 and N1, be given as K. The voltage applied is V1. And the output voltage drop is V2. The current flowing in the primary winding is I1 and that in the secondary winding is I2. Now looking at the diagram, you can easily spot two separate circuits. They are electrically isolated, meaning there is no wire which links either of the two circuits, but they are magnetically coupled. So, analyzing such a transformer circuit is difficult. With impedance transformation, we can get one circuit instead of two, and that makes the analysis much more easy. Let us say you have this circuit, and for making analysis simpler, you are going to convert it to this form. Now, since you are adding Z1 on primary side and removing Z2 from the secondary side, the value of Z1 will not be the same as Z2. It will be somewhat different. What is it? Let's find out. The equation for impedance Z2 can be written as V2 divided by I2. If this Z2 is to be expressed in terms of V1 and I1, then we have to convert V2 and I2 suitably. As per the voltage transformation ratio in the red box, the relation between N2 and N1, V2 and V1, I1 and I2 is given by K. Using these relations, V2 is written as K times V1 and I2 is I1 divided by K. Simplifying this, you get K square into V1 divided by I1. That is Z2 equals to K square into Z1. Hence, the impedance which appears as Z2 in secondary can be written as Z1 in primary, but its value will be given as Z2 divided by K square. This Z1 is also called as reflected impedance. You can derive a relation for what would happen if you had to transfer a resistance from one circuit to another. For that, we use a simple concept that in a transformer, the total power consumed at input equals that at the output. From earlier videos, you know that in a RL circuit, it's only R that consumes power and not L. Hence, you can use the relation I1 square R1 equals I2 square R2. Rearranging the terms and simplifying using the transformation ratio discussed previously, you will find that K square R1 equals R2. So, if you are taking a resistance from secondary to primary, then that resistance will be called as R2 dash. We call this procedure as resistance transfer with reference to primary, and the value of the resistance will be given as R2 divided by K square. On the other hand, if you want to transfer a resistance from primary to secondary circuit, then the procedure is called as resistance transfer with reference to secondary. The new resistance R1 dash will be equal to K square into R1. The same concept applies for reactance as well. If reactance transfer is desired, then the relation that is to be used is that inductance is directly proportional to square of number of turns. Taking a ratio of primary to secondary and simplifying, you will get X1 equal to X2 divided by K square. If reactance is transferred with reference to primary, then the new reactance is called as X2 dash, its value being given as X2 divided by K square. If reactance is transferred with reference to secondary, Then you add x1 dash in the circuit, and its value is given as k square into x1. You see from above relations that you multiply resistance, reactance, and impedance by k square if transferring them from primary to secondary circuit. Similarly, you divide resistance, reactance, and impedance by k square if transferring them from secondary to primary circuit. However, the voltage gets multiplied by k if going from primary to secondary, and gets divided by k if transferred from secondary to primary. The current is divided by k if transferred from primary to secondary, and is multiplied by k if going from secondary to primary. Now consider the equivalent circuit of a transformer. I have previously done a video on how to draw this circuit step by step. You can find the link in the description. The load current I0 in this circuit is very negligible in comparison to the load current I2 and also the current in primary circuit I1. So we can safely eliminate I0 and the elements that are carrying this current. Since we are talking about impedance transfer, there will be only one circuit. Hence the coils are also eliminated. Now you have two resistances, two reactances, one load impedance, and one power supply. If impedance has to be transferred with reference to primary, then only primary current will be considered. So neglect all the other currents. The values of terms in the secondary circuit will change. The new value of resistance R2 dash, reactance X2 dash, and load impedance ZL will all be divided by k square. The voltage drops will change accordingly. Since you have two resistances and two reactances, combine them both individually. The combined resistance will be R1 plus R2 dash. This is written as R0, and since we are referring the circuit with respect to primary, we write a 1 next to R0. So the combined resistance is R0 1. Similarly, X1 plus X2 dash is written as X0 1. The equivalent impedance with respect to primary is Z0 1, given by square root of R0 1 square plus X0 1 square. For impedance transfer with reference to secondary, you get R1 dash and X1 dash as the new terms. In addition, there is transfer of power supply as well, and that value will be given as K times V1. When the resistances and reactances are combined, you get effective resistance with reference to secondary as R02 and the effective reactance as X02. The equivalent impedance with respect to secondary is Z02, given by square root of R02 square plus X02 square. That is it about impedance transfer. Do check out the other videos in the playlist and subscribe to stay updated with Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.